I need to know how to fix a jailbroken iPad.
I get it, since you can't get it fixed under the warranty because it is jailbroken.
Then there's the question as to how I can fix it myself.
Restore to its defaults and take it into the Apple Genius Bar and hope they don't realize it was jailbroken, jailbreaked, whatever they call it.
Whatever the proper term, it is just broken now.
The site Make a Usoft's suggestion is to download iTunes or update it to the latest version. Go to Settings, pick iCloud and turn off disabled Find My iPad.
I know you can use the Find My iPad tool to put a message on the iPad that says if lost call me at such and such number.
You can also use it to wipe the memory of the device to restore to factory defaults so there's no personal data on it. And you'll need it to disable the activation lock.
I don't want to lose all my data.
That's why you want to update iTunes and hope you've already saved your data to the cloud. The next step is connecting the iPad to a Mac with a USB cable and selecting the device in iTunes when it pops up.
I suppose that's when I hit Restore.
Yes. And it will be under the Summary tab.
After I do the Restore, I'll probably have to update the operating system.
Actually, a lot of people have to do a Restore on a jailbroken device just to update the iOS. Because updating iTunes and the iOS after jailbreaking regularly resulted in activation problems.
It makes me wonder if the jailbreak is worth it.
It depends on why you wanted freedom in the first place. But if you want to retain the jailbreak, you should decline the option to create a backup.
I'm guessing that's because jailbreak plus update equals blue screen of death.
After it has been restored, stay connected and use your Apple ID to log in. If you have to do a restore, try to do so using backups from before the jailbreak.
Of course, so that it doesn't look like I did anything really wrong before getting the geniuses at the Genius Bar to fix it.
You could undo the jailbreak with a restore as a new device via iTunes using a stock IPSW file.
I've heard of downloading the IPSW file locally so you don't get iTunes errors when doing a restore.
The difference in that case is that instead of picking to restore the device from iTunes, you hit Shift and Restore and pick the IPSW file you downloaded.
What if iTunes isn't working or unavailable?
If you relied on the jailbreak for access to the device because it was someone else's, the device is bricked. If both the device and software errors are your problem, go to Settings, General, Reset, Erase All Content and Settings.
I'll get a confirmation message at that point.
All the apps and information is deleted, including most traces of a jailbreak. Then you get to go through all the setup, including restoring iTunes, just like it was new.
Just like new is better than it is today.